name is Robert Kelly. We're here at Gold's Gym, getting a little workout on, a little training advice. I've been working out for more than 20 years now. I'm 40 now, and I've been a competitive bodybuilder for about 15 years. My next show will be in July. I'll be doing the Junior USAs in California, and then I'll probably go to Toronto and do the North American Championships. So I'm looking forward to that, trying to gain my pro card, so it'll be a big challenge. So we're here today to show you some couple of training techniques and try to introduce you to training and see if you like it, and you like it, get more active. Let's get in shape. I would guess say when you're saying much, it's kind of a relative term because I eat often during the day, maybe 5 to 6 times, but it's not very, the portion is not very big. A lot of people eat once or twice a day, but they eat a lot of carbohydrates and fats, and a lot of meal portions are real big. So they don't give the body time enough to, you know, metabolize it and digest, so that's where your fat comes in. But if you eat more often during the day in smaller portions, it allows your body to metabolize it and, you know, work it off. So therefore you eat more often, but that not that much. So kind of a trade-off. You eat more often for less of it.
Is there a certain point at the end of the night that you cut off eating?
Yeah, it all depends. Now if you're trying to gain weight, good muscle mass weight, you want to eat maybe an hour before you go to bed, because if you don't eat all that time, your body tends to burn muscle throughout the night. But if you're trying to lose weight or maintain, you don't want to eat after 7 o'clock. And you try to cut the carbohydrates down after about 1 or 2 o'clock in the afternoon.
Okay, so no eating after 7, and you can wake up and just go to town at what time?
I normally get up on a normal day for me, it's about 6 o'clock. Okay. And I get up and I may eat like 8 egg whites and a bowl of oatmeal. That'll be my morning. Get a lot of protein and your carbohydrates. You want to eat more carbohydrates before noon so it can give you energy for your workout. You don't want to eat that many afterwards because your body tends to store that overnight, and that's how you end up picking up body fat as well.
Exactly. What's going to happen here?
All right. What we're doing here, we're going to do some weighted actual pull-ups. Normal pull-ups works more of your latissimus dorsalis, that's your back muscles. And once you get pretty, proficient at it, you can add weight, so it adds more weight, so it makes it more difficult. First, I'll demonstrate a normal one without the weight, and then I'll do a couple with the weight. So here we go. Make sure normally your arms about a little more than shoulder width apart. And then just simply pull your body up to the bar. Make sure your chin comes up to the bar so you get a full stretch. And then go all the way down, extend your arms all the way down.
Here.
All right, now we're doing the pull-ups with the additional weight. Sometimes when you get proficient at it, you get stronger and stronger. You can do more than 10 or 12 reps. You want to add weight so you can actually get a better workout for your back.
Perfect.
All right, next I guess we're gonna move to do a little bench press here. This is normally the guy's favorite workout. Favorite exercise, because this normally demonstrates how strong you are. But what it does, it actually works your overall chest, makes your major chest muscles, the lower chest, and your minor chest muscles, your upper chest. So we're gonna get a couple demonstrations, sets in here for you. So we'll start off warm up weightlifting. Now the key to doing this is to make sure when you're lifting, you arch your back off the bench, keep your butt flat on the bench, just use your arms to press the weight. Another thing, always make sure you use a spotter when lifting.
You gonna go up?
After you get warmed up, that's normally a warm up where you get your muscles loose. You can go up to your target weight. We're gonna do our 225 today, do a couple sets for you. It's always good maybe to also, and then when you're lifting, your protective equipment. Check your back, you might want to use a weight belt to make sure you don't have any unnecessary injuries.
Now you lift in competition, right?
Normally I don't do powerlifting competitions. When I lift, it's for the actual bodybuilding competitions. Powerlifting is the exercises are normally totally different. You do a lot of core movements, a lot of power movements. Your repetition is normally lower. You do maybe three to five reps when you're doing powerlifting. When you're bodybuilding, you know, higher rep range, maybe from 8 to 10, 6 to 10, depending on, you know, the time of the year.
You got a couple of competitions coming up worldwide, is that correct?
Yes, I have one in July. It'll be out in California. It'll be the Junior USAs. One in Toronto in September, North American Championships.
Fantastic.
That's the bench press. So like I said, once again, that's the major for your chest, the basic chest exercises. You can incorporate more things once you get more advanced, but this is the basic one for your chest.
What's next?
All right, let's go over here. Do a couple of curls. This is for your biceps, your middle,
and ladies and gentlemen, the shirt comes up.
So this is for the biceps. This is the middle upper part of your arm. The lower part is your tricep. And a lot of times when you're doing bench press, it also works the tricep. But this part, bicep, where you work on the peak of your arm. Also, when you're doing your back, like when I was doing the pull-ups, that works that part. Like I say, this is working more the biceps of your arm, your peaks, where, you know, when you have your shirt off and when you're working those, wearing those tank tops at the beach.
When all the guys, when you come down to the beach, all the guys are like, oh man, hey, can't he walk somewhere else?
So we start with underhand grip. Bring it off and you switch what you do, just try to stay as straight as possible, back as straight as possible. Bring the weight, curl the weight up to the nose. And also, that works your forearm, this part of your arm a little bit. I guess it's like an auxiliary workout. But mainly, like I said before, it's to work your peak of your arm. So when you do this flexing, you know, all the girls go wow.
That's my man.
the dumbbell, we're gonna do a dumbbell lying press. This works your chest also. Like I was saying, the bench is the main exercise for your chest, but this is an auxiliary exercise that actually helps build the inner part of your chest.
Now, is that a industry standard where after you get done with the weights, you just throw them down like that?
That's a good job. It all depends on what gym you're in, but you know, if you're lifting enough weight, it makes you look like you're lifting even more when you drop them like that.
There you go. Supporting technique. There throw the go. Weights down. No, I ask because I see a lot of people doing that.
Yeah, a lot of times, they always tell me when I was coming up, when I first started. If you're not dropping it, you're not doing enough. That means you control it. So if you're supposed to go to failure. So when they say go to failure, it's that when you're lifting, you can't do enough rep. So therefore, you're not dropping it. You're not doing enough weight.
There you go.
That's old school.
Okay, so what we got next?
Let's get the squat in. Now we're gonna do the squat today on a what we call a Smith machine. The reason being is squat is probably the most dangerous exercise that you can do. And if you don't have a spotter, you should always use the Smith machine because it acts as a spotter for you. Now squat is probably the basic, most important exercise in overall body development. Because when you do the squat, you actually use over 200 muscles in your body. Starting with your back, your legs, thighs, neck, arms. So overall, it's really considered an overall body movement, but a lot of people use it for your legs, and that's the major mass builder for your legs. So we're going to do a couple warm-ups here. Now Emmanuel here wants me to hurt myself, so we'll go heavy a little bit. Always advisable to wear your weight belt.
What's the benefits of the nutrition drinks? Or I heard somebody refer to it as muscle milk. What is that?
Now it all depends on really what nutritional drinks were actually devised for. It's a meal supplement or meal replacement. Some it all depends. Now, if you're drinking a protein drink, it's like 9 times out of 10, if you're just normally trying to work out, gain a little muscle, stay fit, I don't advocate spending a lot of money in GNC or the protein shakes. Because what it is, if you're not eating right, it allows you to supplement a meal. Say if you're on the road and you can't eat right, instead of going to McDonald's or Burger King, some fast food joint, you can get you a protein shake where it can give you, you know, you have enough vitamins and minerals and actually amino acids, so you can skip that burger and have a protein shake.
Okay.
Now some different, like the energy drinks, they have different things in them that gives you energy. A lot of them have caffeine in it, so it really is not an energy drink. It just keeps you up and jittery, keeps you moving, like drinking coffee.
Okay.
So we start out, make sure you have a solid base up under you. Release the bar, and then we're just going straight down and back up. Completed the warm-up.
That's a warm-up?
It's a warm-up. Let's go ahead and get to the heavy stuff right quick.
Oh my goodness.
All right now, when I say heavy, that's me, this is like one or two times. So.
How much weight you got on here right now?
This is about 315
pounds.
Right.
So that's about two grown men and maybe a child. Do you do like push-ups with like one of your kids on your back and stuff like that?
You know what? Actually, I hate all asymmetric exercises, so I don't do push-ups. I hate them.
Wow.
It's more. They're not good. I'm not saying that they're not good. They're actually a very good exercise, but it's just kind of boring to me because now you know you get to a point where you have to do 100, 150 to be any you know youth. So it's just like monotonous. So I just really come to the gym. So I can actually see the weight that I'm putting on.
Okay.
But don't get me wrong, push-ups are a good exercise, especially if you don't have time to make it to the gym. You can do variations of push-ups, you can do straight push-ups, you can put your feet up on a chair and do angle push-ups. So push-ups are a very good overall body exercise.
Okay.
All right, let's get to it. One more out of this.
There we go. We got the yellow now.
That's it.
We're back here.
That's it.
We finished our workout for today. I hope that you know this is inspiring to a lot of people where you can stop, get off the couch, get in shape. It'll make you feel better, have more youth, more vitality, have better energy for your everyday activities. I work out here at Gold's Gym. Gold's Gym has been an icon of the fitness for over 65 years. This one is located in Conyers. Have an array of good machines, classes that you can take, aerobic activity, and it's really never very, very crowded. So if you're ever in the area, you want to come check out those, feel free. I'm sure they'll work.